Here in France, a report by a climate watchdog that was set up by the French president himself has slammed the president's government for lagging on its promises to the planet. To talk about this with me now, I'm joined on the set by our environment editor, Mairéad Dundas. Mairéad, what's so surprising here is how bad this report really is for President Macron himself.
Yes, indeed, and it's certainly a rebuttal to those who had feared that this watchdog set up by the president himself wouldn't have any teeth, because in its first report that's come out this morning, it makes it very clear that the government is falling well short of its promises to act on climate change. There was 11 environment experts set up in what is known as the High Council for Climate. And it comes at a time, one, when France is suffering through a huge heat wave, which is unseasonable for June, and at the same time, at a time when Emmanuel Macron is continuing to bill himself as somewhat of a climate crusader. It's a 50-page report, and its overall message is severely critical. It says, yes, France has ambitious objectives. That's well and good, but its actions are insufficient. And it actually says in the report that France would need to triple its efforts to get back on track.
So give us some of the details here. What are the biggest criticisms against France?
Well, number one, it says that France's greenhouse gas emissions haven't fallen nearly as much as they should have. If we have a look there, we've got only 1.1% a drop over the period 2005 to 2008. 2015 to 2018, when the objective was nearly double that. Second observation, France has no chance of reaching carbon neutrality. Now, the irony is that right now the parliament is considering draft legislation with exactly that goal in mind. Now, the report points its finger at two principal causes. Transport, number one, 31% of emissions. And in fact, people didn't make the transition to electric and hybrid cars in the way that the government had predicted or forecast. Other problem there, buildings, which we don't always talk about a lot, but 19% of emissions, largely because our homes just are not insulated well enough.
And which is interesting too, because there's so little air conditioning here in France, you would think it wouldn't be that high. Does this report give any solutions to what France should be doing, or the French should be doing, to make things better?
Well, among its solutions is the infamous carbon tax, which we all know is what caused the yellow vest protest movement and sparked so much outcry. However, the council here makes it very clear that they require more transparency and equality in developing this carbon tax. The other proposal, that climate subsidies for fossil fuels should end, they've doubled in the last 10 years. Now, the Prime Minister, Edouard Philippe, has acknowledged the report, saying that climate policies should be amplified given the urgency. Now, we've heard this for a long time, but he has promised a response from the government to these recommendations early next month.
Mairéad, thank you so much. Our environment editor, Mairéad Dundas, always great to have you on the show. Thank you very much. All right.